G'day guys. Back again. Hope you're all doing well. Haven't done too many reviews of these little Panzer Art 135 scale figures, but this one caught my eye. Just like the pose of it. And I think I've done one or two Panzer Art figures before, if you go through my library of videos. This one is the US Army tanker in Ardennes No. 1. And I quite like the pose. I like it. Is it the, is that the M3 submachine gun or whatever you call it, grease gun? And I quite like how he's holding something in his other's hands. And for some reason, I'm just a sucker for the tanker helmets, the US tanker helmets, especially with the sort of, whatever you want to call them, the goggles on top, whatever. So let's have a quick look at this one. So this one will be reasonably quick to put together. You can see most of the body there with one arm. Comes in one piece, and I do like how you've got this little sling for his gun there going straight through his hand. I think that looks pretty realistic. I like the creases on the trousers. You got this little pocket there on the side and on the back. There's a couple of little minor casting lines. At first I thought this was a casting line coming up the side there, but that is actually a part of his jacket. I thought at first this was a misalignment. And so I got online, because this one isn't as bad, or when I was thinking of it, and then when I got online I realized that is actually the design of the tanker's jacket. So that put me at ease a little bit. But as you can see, the strap comes around the back there. Close up of his boots. You can see where the casting line sort of comes up a little bit. Sort of runs up his leg a little bit. Just there. It's not too bad. It's not majorly worrying. I don't know if we shop on this side, so it runs up his leg and sort of just comes out. You can just see it just coming out there. Just runs up here a little bit. It sort of gets fainter when it comes to the top. Again, you get the nice little location holes for the other parts. I do like this one, how it's actually holding the piece in his hands. Just a lot more realistic. I really like that. There's not too many figures that you get. Well, modern resin ones, newer ones, they're actually holding something in their hands. So I think that's quite nice, especially for a US tanker, especially with the amount of Tamiya sort of modern tanks, the M10 that's coming out, or has come out, and the Hellcat and all that. It's quite nice to be getting some new US tankers. Obviously, Alpine's done a fair few as well. The other thing that was nice about this that I didn't realize is you actually do get two heads in this set as well. It seemed to come out better when I had my hands on them. But they're quite nice, they're not too bad. Both of these heads are nice. Often you get sort of heads where you like one or the other. But I quite like both of these. They're nicely detailed. You can see all the straps around the side of the helmet there. The goggles just has that tiny little bit coming down in the middle on the front. I do like the side profile of these guys. I think they look really nice. The faces. I'll just show you the other side. As you can see, for 135 scale, I say it a fair bit, but we're getting a bit spoilt, guys. We're getting a bit spoilt. We're coming up with some really nice figures these days. Just the back there. You can see a little bit of a casting line coming up the back of the helmet there, but again, it's not too bad. It's nothing. Horrific. And just the back of the tanker's helmet there on top. I like this. I really actually do like this figure. There is another figure that sort of comes with this one, like in a different box, or sometimes they sell them as a set. So if you like this one, you can check out the other one that sort of accompanies this guy. I didn't buy that, I just sort of picked this one up. Little grease gun, and it's really nice detail on this. It's very fine. You obviously have to be very careful cutting these little attachment points off, but it's a really nice, quietly detailed little machine gun there. I think Dragon used to have one of these in one of their tanker sets as well. That must be to attach to his body, I'm guessing. A little bit more interesting. I wonder if that's where he attaches it to his body, just to hold it out. And you see that side, because I think that sort of, sort of sits in underneath his arm there, if you like. Yeah, quite like that. Chop off is actually just on the actual attachment point. So this bit stays, which is nice. And I just tried this for a second, and it's a really nice fit. Look at that. Again. Let's see if I can hold it from the back here. Probably push in a little bit more. I'm not pressing firmly. And then I'll just attach the arm and the rest of it. And this one just slides in there. I just chopped that off with quickly with these. So I didn't really use a hobby knife or anything. So it's not going to be fitting perfectly. So I've just blue tacked his arm and his head on. So there's, it's a little bit more of a spacing than what it should be. But the only thing I noticed, which, obviously they probably all didn't have, but I did notice that they didn't have a little pistol pouch or holster sort of thing on this one. But other than that, I quite like it. I like the way his little grease gun's going to sort of slide in under there. For a standalone figure, or just, one just standing in front of a tank to show the size of the tank or tank destroyer or whatever, I think he's a really nice little figure. Slap the other head on for you. And there's the other head there. There you go, guys. That's just another quick look at a 135 scale Panzer art figure. There's the code there if you're looking for it. US Army tanker in Ardennes No. 1. I quite like him. As always, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.